Okay, this is curious. I got partway through the next mission, and I saved it, and now I'm back, and I can't seem to access my save anymore. It is not allowing me to quick load it. So, I guess we're going back in from the start then. We need to misplace some paintings in order to proceed with the next mission. And so here we are, doing the titular Art Vandals mission. Now, we'll have a look around to begin with. I'll show you where everything is, because I'm already familiar with it to an extent now. So we've got a nice little ramp here. And then if we come over here and climb up this flight of stairs, we've got target number one. This one we just snatch. There's a mix of snatch and grab heavy objects on this mission. So, from there, number two can be reached by coming across here and going up this ramp. And this one is a heavy object. It's a big bugger, so we can lug it slowly back to base. Part of my plan was lugging it slowly back to base. I knocked the floor out, and then I was trying to drag it back, but I just kept running out of time. Just grabbing it from down here. I grabbed that first one, ran across here, grabbed it from down here, and tried to run it back. Broke this open. Broke that open. Tried to get out with it. Wasn't really working out, so we're going to need to come up with a better plan than that. Now, let's see. There's this little bridge here that we didn't really use in any of my previous plans, but this allows us to get across to number three, which we can see from down here. It's a chair. That's about all there is to say about that one. It's a chair, and it's suspended over there. Number four is over here in the museum storage. And this one we may as well try and extract now to some extent. Let's just get that door open. Get that open a bit. And here's number four. So we don't want it down here because that's just a pain in the bum. So let's... Oh, I hear cats scrapping. Back in a mo. Right, problem solved. Sammy was getting all agitated at Eric being at the window again. As happens frequently. Now, this painting we should be able to pull outside. The cable seems to not mind glitching through the floor. I've noticed that previously. But here's something I want to know. Is there any way we can sort of knock out the wall up there and do a big blue side jump to get up there? So we'd want a plank, faux show. And then let's see, we'd go, woo! So that would be a normal non-blue tide related jump. Because if we can just jump that, that would be a great time saver on our run. Where would we be jumping from? Where would we be jumping to? And then where would we be going? Out there, I guess? I haven't worked this out. We're making it up as we go along. Let's break that open. That gives us a target of sorts. So we grab that one, let's drop a quick save so we can test it with a bit of blue tide. Whee! So we can do that. And then we could grab that one, and then we could be out this window, I guess. So in order to pull that off, we want this chair to be over here a bit. We'll pick it up. We'll jump it across there. Good. Don't fall out the window, plus. That will set off your cable. So we pick that one up, and then we're going to head over here. I don't want to break that ladder because I don't know if it's going to be needed. But then we'll go up, run down here. We could potentially cut this corner, you know. We could potentially put a cable over here. And then, oops, we've fallen in. I didn't want to fall in. This is why I'm glad we haven't broken the ladder. Because we're going to come up here. And then let's see. There's our cable. Is it going to allow us to... Yeah, that's too far. Okay. But if we hook it up there and across here... And now we've fallen off this side. I'm not good at movement. It's a miracle I've been able to get as far as I have in this game. I've fallen off again. I'm not even sure if this is going to be necessary. But yeah, you can stretch a cable across there. And then you can put planks on the cable. I believe. Maybe you can't. I'm sure I've seen a speedrunner do something similar. But either way then, we'll probably just blue-tide our way along here. The next target is going to be that thing that's up in the ceiling there. So we probably want to work our way up there. So we'll put a plank over here just to enable us to get up and down easy. And then we'll put a plank over here. There's another target. That's another heavy one that we're going to have to take back by hand, as it were. But first of all, we'll get this arachnid down. Because we want this at ground level. There we go. So we're going to work our way across from the chair to here, where we're going to grab this one. And then we're going to grab that one. But how are we going to get that one back? Well, part of it's going to involve getting these trees out of the way. So let's chop them down, and then we'll deal with them momentarily. But I have found a decently efficient way of dealing with the trees, and that's our friend over here. The old combine harvester. It's got its little rotary thing on the front, and it can crunch up trees pretty good. Crunchy chomp. Chompy crunch. There we go. I mean, it helps if the trees are actually falling over, but maybe we can toss them into the sea. The sea? The pool. And even if we can't, they get ground up to mulch pretty well. Maybe we'll also drive through here and just clear out part of that building, because that will probably come in handy also. Lovely. So we've kind of cleared out the trees, more or less. There's this little bit, I guess, but we can probably just pick that up and toss that over there. Yeah, we've mostly cleared a path, because we're going to be driving that one back to base. Which vehicle should we use? Either way, first things first, we need to find a vehicle and get it on the roof of the museum, because we're going to need that for the big heavy one. and I feel like there's a pretty easy way to get a vehicle up on the roof, so let's try and see if we can't do that. We're going to make our way up and onto this ramp here at the top. Drop a quick save because I don't know if this is going to work. I'm going to try and break these supports that are holding this roof in place. This long ass beam we don't need, so we'll just take this away. And we'll drop it into the pool. Now, what's holding this roof up here now? That back bit, I guess. And then that's being held in place down there. But that's fine. That back bit. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that roof is just being held in place now by sheer force of will. And if we were to break it at the back end, it should drop down and become a nice little ramp for us. So let's see if we can't give that a go. Okay, it's fallen at the wrong end. Maybe it was still hooked up at the top. I mean, it's definitely not hooked up on that side. It doesn't look like it's hooked up on this side either, though. Anyway, let's loosen that. Oh yeah, I guess it was. There we go. Right, we may have made a ramp now that allows us to get up onto this building. And there's already a ramp there, which is nice. So we'll just crack this open. Alright, hopefully we've not caused too much damage. And now we need to find a vehicle. So a 4x4 or something of that ilk would be suitable for this, I feel. Much like the one over here. I feel like this one in the building is the key to getting things right. Because this is the one that I was having the most trouble doing in a time-efficient fashion the last time I tried this. Oh, yeah. That's working. So that's good. It's quick as well, which is nice. Oops. Forward and right, back and left. Forward and right, back and left. Looking good. Yep, it's looking pretty good. All told. Need to move those poufets out of the way. And now we need to find some way to affix that thing to this Jeep. So we need to pop it off the wall. Very good. And now, can we lift it? And can we manipulate it onto the top of this Jeep? And then can we fix it in place with cables? Or will we need to use planks? It definitely fits on top of the Jeep. That's good. Now, I feel like cables would be the thematic choice, but they do seem to... be a bit stretchy for our needs. So let's see how this works. This looks like it might be promising. Should we test it? Oh, it's a bit wobbly, but pretty much works. Well, it works until we throw ourselves off. But it works, that's the main thing. So let's say that's our first. And then once we drop it off, how do we get to this other one up here? Because we could go from that one to the Jeep. But that involves some running. Can we dangle this one out of a window? In a manner that allows us to pick it up before we then drive off and get the one at museum storage. What happens if we try that? Yeah, we can certainly pull it loose. And we can throw it out the window. There's a platform out there. Do we want it on this platform, or do we want to take out the platform as well? See how low it goes. What if we just do that? Then it breaks. Okay. Should probably have seen that breakage coming. What if we instead left it where it was? Grabbed it. Came up and out of the skylight. Cross and... Oh. That's almost doable. Or it's just doable. It's just straight up doable. Just need to make the hole a bit bigger. Which is fine. So we can start with that first one. We could do a running jump. What if we put a plank out just to try and make our lives easier? Would that work? Certainly wouldn't if it's in that sort of shape. But what if we put it across like that? Then it gives us something to aim at. Right, so yeah, we leave that one there, and then we can pick it up from here, can't we? Although, let's lift it up at this end. Because we want that end to be a bit closer to where we're going. Good. Does that allow us to grab it from here? It does. So we grab that one. We run up here and out. We do a flying leap onto our plank. And we get in the vehicle. Yeah, that works. Right, so we've got the first two. We're going to drive back to here, and then we're going to drop off those two. So now we need a vehicle. Is this a quick car? Feels like it could be quick. So we'll line this up over here somewhere. And we're going to use that to race across there, get that one. So I think the only thing now that we need to worry about is how do we get the last one? And I think the answer again is going to be strapping it to a vehicle, possibly with planks. So we need another fast vehicle. It's our old friend Monster. So let's bring it down nice and careful like. As is our traditional style, we're known for the care and attention to detail that we bring to Teardown. Yeah, this ground's a bit rough, so monster should do the job nicely. And it's small enough to fit under there. First time I did this mission, I was using a big crane to try and bring this one back. Just because it's got a grippy bit on it, so it seemed like a good bet. And I had to demolish, like, basically all of that wooden bit and sink it into the pool to try and get the job done. It did not work. No. I also ended up with a boat in this pool to see if we could lower that one onto a boat. Guess what? That didn't work either. Now, can we hook a cable up to that? Not if we fall in the water. Should have probably saved, quick save before I jumped in the water to save myself this run back. Right. Okay, there we go. Got a cable hooked up. Can it reach anything over here? Not quite. So that's not even going to work, but what if we just pop that out and grab it and bring it back over here manually? Right. Yeah, because we can grab it from there, no trouble. Maybe we need a crane to fish it out of the water. Maybe that would be wise. Fortunately, thanks to my previous exploits on this map, which is the term I use instead of failure for what I spent an hour and a half doing before, I do know where there are cranes. So let's go and rescue this one, shall we? Be free, my friend. We have need of your services once again. Don't worry about this lamppost. Do worry about this propane truck, though. That's not required for this mission, I feel. Okay, let's see if we can't do this. We should be able to do this, right? We know it's down there somewhere. We may have moved it too close to the edge, actually. Maybe a plank will be the answer to our problems once again. Is that connected? Yeah, it is. Let's see if this works. And no, it hasn't worked. Never mind. Can we just lift up this structure a bit? We can, but then can we get it to stay lifted? Or does it just fall back in? It just falls back in. What if we try hooking a plank from that to that? That might work. There we go, that's worked. So, what we want to do is basically just drop that on there. Lovely. And then to be on the safe side, we'll hop out and we'll break those planks if we can. Because we don't need those anymore. But you stay there, please. We'll come this way a bit. There we go. Mission accomplished. Now, can we move the cage onto the back of Monstro without any serious issues with alarms going off? No, it falls down. But the alarm hasn't gone off. This is good. Let's see what we can do then. There we go. Oops. And now more planks to hook up this thing to Monstro. And hopefully that's hooked up. And now we can actually go and give things a try. What's going on down there? Sammy is racing around like the maddest goblin on the planet. It's all riled up from her encounter with Eric, and now she's just raring for a fight with anything. So let's get our blue tide at the ready. Drop a quick save. And let's go. Maybe with the blue tide, actually, yeah. We can make that jump even easier. Or maybe we overshoot it. So let's go again. I mean, it does speed up the running across here, but... Oh, I mean, that is a tricky jump. Could have put more planks down. Too lazy to do now. And there we go. Now, driving the old Jeep down. Careful-like. And we're in one piece. Wow. So we drop that off. May as well just keep driving this bugger. Hopefully that doesn't break our plank. It did move it a bit. And then we go out here. The blue tide helps us a bit. There. Grab the arachnid. And is this going to work? It is. So we drive around, careful-like. We missed it. We missed it. And we did it. Oof! We nearly botched it at the end there, but we got all six. Time left 1.6 seconds. Oof! Tricky. That hour and a bit that I spent off camera, well, technically off camera, recorded it all and then realised it was trash. But that hour and a bit was required to learn the lay of the land here. And so we find ourselves back at Woo Manor once again. Let's see. Pumphrey. That's a nice nickname. We need the Crown Zagots parked in the ocean garage. Amantide and I were supposed to continue racing after lunch, but now it started raining. So we'll stay at the mall. So he's chums with Mr. Amantide. Go to one of the race cars. I guess the race cars are down on the racetrack. Or thereabouts. Here they are. And... yeah, which one did we... it's probably this one that we painted, because this is the one we covered in yellow spray paint, I feel. Park the car in the ocean garage, so off we go. I guess this is just showing modders the sorts of other objectives that they can do. Is this the ocean garage? Oh no, the ocean garage will be the garage that's next to the ocean, won't it? So yeah, over we go. And in we go. And let's park her up. Just on here. Lovely. And then you want us to do the same with the other one, I guess? A nice little relaxing job this is after... the excitement of that last mission. As long as we don't botch it horribly. All done. Lovely. So we're going to find out what our next mission is now. Seems like. Did we park the cars? We did. No security cameras in the museum. The outdoor ones we could explain, with you being a teen doing teen stuff. But the ones inside, we should really get a hold of. So we're going to be stealing security cameras. That sounds like an exciting job for next time.